Okay, today we have Mark Pody and Clark Boyd with us, our state representative and our, what's the other
one? Senator.
Senator, I'm sorry, went blank. And they want Gary to come up front, Gary Hancock. They have something for him. And then Gary's gonna talk a little bit about the history of the bank and the post office that he's just refurbished and restored. And it, if you haven't been down to see it, you need to go see it because it looks really good. But we're going to ask Clark, Mark, and Gary to come to the front.
Right over here. There we go. Right here.
Thank you, Karen. And Gary, on behalf of the state of Tennessee, the state Senate, and the state House of Representatives, we want to present a proclamation to honor you and to honor Dassaway on some of the things that are going on here. So if you'll indulge me for just a minute, I'm gonna read from it. It says, whereas it is our privilege to recognize those Tennessee institutions that serve as cultural touchstones and contribute to the endearing legacy of the great cities that comprise the Volunteer State. And whereas on June the 1st of 2019, the Dassaway Museum will have its grand opening as part of the Dassaway Homecoming, ushering in a new era for the town of Dassaway. Whereas the Dassaway Museum is located in the edifice that was once Melton's Bank of Dassaway, chartered in 1903 by George G. Melton and his sons, John and Jim, the bank opened that same year inside the Melton Mercantile Store. And whereas in 1925, a new structure was built beside the store and the Melton's Bank moved the following year to the Dassaway Post Office, established in 1890. Relocated from a store on the east side of the Clear Fork Creek to the new bank building in 1926. Whereas Melton's Bank served the community of Dassaway for the next six decades, including the Great Depression, though it was not an FDIC institution. In fact, the bank eventually became the last uninsured depository in the state. And in 1987, Melton's Bank was purchased by the First National Bank of Manchester and closed 6 months later. And whereas in the years since, the building that once housed the bank and the Dassaway Post Office has been neglected and fallen into disrepair, the revitalization of the structure and the installment of a community museum is the result of the passion and hard work of Gary and Jamie Hancock, lifelong residents of Dassaway. And whereas having grown up together and graduated from Woodbury Central High School, Gary and Jamie Hancock have deep roots in the community as well as ties to the former bank. Both sets of their parents banked there, and Gary recalls opening a checking account there as a young man. And whereas in 2017, Mr. Hancock approached the grandson of Melton's Bank, last banker, about purchasing the building, and once the purchase was final, he and his wife set themselves to the task of cleaning and repairing the building. Whereas the Hancocks' efforts included acquiring pieces that were original to the building, while many of the original furnishings had remained at the bank, the front of the teller's cage, the centerpiece of the bank, has been repurposed as the ticket cage in the Airspace Museum in Manchester upon the bank's closing in 1987. And whereas in addition to returning the 10-foot long and 7-foot high teller's cage to its rightful home, the Hancocks installed wood windows, which the building originally had, and they uncovered various hidden gems from the building's past, including old deposit books, ledgers, cemetery deeds, and typewriters, as well as a 1925 map of the United States and an old Cannon County map that shows postal routes of the time. And whereas the Dassaway Museum is truly a boon to the people of the town and is certain to be a Tennessee treasure and an endearing symbol of the rich history of our state, now therefore, let it be proclaimed that I, Randy McNally, Speaker of the Senate of the 111th General Assembly of the State of Tennessee, at the request of and in conjunction with Senator Mark Pody and Representative Clark Boyd, do hereby proclaim that we congratulate the citizens of Dassaway on the grand opening of the Dassaway Museum, commend Gary and Jamie Hancock for their hard work in making the museum a reality, and extend our best wishes for the museum's success. And Gary, just want to congratulate you on that, and thank you for taking me through a minute ago. You've done a great job.
Hold on one second.
So,
daughter,
yes, please, if they would come up here with us. You know, I had the opportunity to go through the bank at the post office, and they spent some time with me last week. And I was so impressed and so amazed as we're watching some small towns seem to be folding up and fading away. This community is saying no. This community has roots. It's alive. It's well. It's growing and it's prospering through things that you're doing now, through the investment you're making. Homecoming here year after year, we're so proud of what you all are doing. And I did see this in the paper.
I seen this guy, and he's sitting in the paper, he's sitting in a chair, and I actually cut this out. I cut the article, had it put in here for you to put in there as well. And I'm just going to tell you, I was so impressed with everything that's going on here in Gasway. Congratulations. We're proud of y'all, okay? All right. Thank you.
Gary, you want to say something?
Well, I think that Mr. Boyd's reading of the proclamation pretty well detailed much of the history of the bank, but thanks to the citizens, really, of this community is what it's all about. I thank Randy for really allowing the decision that he made to sell the building and the undertaker shop. And like I said, when started, didn't think it would be as big a job as what it turned out to be, but that's usually the case of repairing old structures. But Emily has helped out, and like I said, it's kind of coincided with our homecoming this year to say everything's complete. It's just like your home. You're never complete. You're always doing something. But again, going back to the history of it, there was transactions that we have of records even prior to 1903, much like when my father run the store here. He was cashing checks. He was loaning people money and things of this nature, and unofficially was not a bank, but he officially acted like a bank. So that's the way that the old Meltons originally started out as a bank. The father and the two sons, both of them progressed on. Sadly, though, they died a few years after the charter was formed. One of them died in 1911, the father, and then the other in 1920 and 1923. But that's when Mr. Jim Kidwell stepped in. Mr. Jim, as I've told others, he kind of became the unofficial attorney, even though he never practiced law, and he became certainly the financial advisor for the community. Back in the 20s and the 30s and the 40s, until his death in the 50s, that he advised the farmers, because that's what it was mainly composed of here, was farmers, how the need to put your livestock together, whether it was cattle or hogs or turkeys, and put them on a train in Brush Creek and take them to Nashville to the livestock market. Buy things that you couldn't buy here in the self-sufficient community, bring them back, better your community. So that's what I hope that this museum does, better the community. So go by and look at it. It's yours. We've asked for pictures from your families. Many of you know the bank because, again, you're of your families, whether it's your father or grandparents, whoever it may be, but it's your museum. We're still not finished, but we're at the point that we had to say it's time to take a break, to say the least. But thank you for visiting, and thank you for the compliments that you've made, and thank Mr. Boyd and Mr. Pody for making this proclamation. Thank you.